Hello there, scrappy friends. Thanks for joining me today for another scrapbook process video. This one is Fall Bliss, and I am scrapbooking about my love for pumpkin spice latte. I am going to be using that stamp set there that I've already actually stamped out, that little coffee cup and a little sentiment there. And I may incorporate some of those K and I company embellishments, as well as I'm using these papers that you see here, and they are from Target from years ago. I picked them up in the Target dollar area years ago, and they are really, really thin papers, but they're so pretty, and I've kept them in my stash instead of donating them because I thought they'd make a great page someday, and I'm so glad I kept them. So I'm just going to do a double mat here with my photos, which I've already trimmed down to size. And I'm going to use that orange with the gold, and then I'm going to back it with that brown kind of hash mark paper just so it pops off of that tan die cut that you see in the back there that says fall. And so if you hear any kind of construction noise, I'm just going to let you know right now that you may hear it. And I am so sorry, but we are having some work done outside on our deck. And it's a little bit noisy. It's not too bad, but the camera may pick it up, so we'll see. Anyways, I'm going to just go ahead and finish matting and get these down. I already have in mind kind of what I want to do for this layout, so it shouldn't take me very long. It was a really quick layout, actually, to do because I had already pre-stamped out my coffee embellishment, and I went ahead and colored it in with some Copics and got that all ready. It just made this such a fast process that I didn't have to think about what embellishments am I going to use because I already created my embellishment prior to making the layout. I really love the tones in this paper. It was a lot of fun to use. Even though the quality of the papers are pretty thin, I really love the colors. And that green stripe there has a gold in it, which is so pretty. And it really pulls in the green from the Starbucks cup. That, like I said, was a cutout that I did for my Cricut. And as you can see, there was a placement, you know, suggested place to put a photo. But I knew that I wasn't going to follow. I just wanted it for the cutout, for the leaves and the word fall. And I'm just going to layer over top of it anyway. And you won't even know that that cutout for a horizontal 4x6 photo was supposed to be there. So this is about the arrangement that I'm going to put my photos in, and I'm thinking that I need some more color, so I'm going to cut a strip off of the striped paper, but it's a little too big. I'm covering up a little bit too much of the die in the background, so I'm going to trim that down to 3 inches, and that's the perfect size. So I'm going to adhere the die on there, and I believe that was from either my Cricut, it could have been my Silhouette. It's been a really long time since I've created any cuts from those machines, but I typically, sometimes if I don't feel like scrapbooking, I will bring out my die cutters and I will go ahead and just cut a bunch of stuff in, you know, solid cardstocks like this that I can use for future projects. I'm going to use these little tiny glue dots to just adhere down the corners of this die, because I did not want it to shift or get caught when I go to put it into the page protector. And my adhesive ATG roller was just too thick to roll some adhesive on the corner. So just went ahead and did that, got that out of the way. And I accidentally grabbed the wrong paper there, and I was like, oh yeah, I wanted the smaller one. So I'm gonna adhere that down. And I love how it just gives that little touch of gold in there as well. And you can still see the leaves, and I just really like this layout a lot. It turned out pretty cute. And then I'm going to go ahead and add in my homemade embellishment up there from my stamp set. And that little round circle I'm holding is actually from the stamp set. It says, Coffee, Create, Sleep, Repeat. And I went ahead and just stamped it directly on some of that orange and gold paper and then punched it out with my circle punch. I thought that would make a cute embellishment since it said create on there with coffee. It was perfect. I'm going to adhere all these down. slightly angled in different directions, and I really like that look. I'm trying not to cover up the actual pumpkin spice latte logo on the cup there because I wanted it to be seen. And I thought I was going to use those, and then I decided not to. There's some embellishments on this set here from Kay and Company that will work so much better. The colors match a lot better. And the little stamped image that I created, I'm going to go ahead and put that on some foam adhesive and attach that up there next to the word fall. And I just love how that turned out. I am going to alter that just a tiny bit. I'm going to add some gold Winkostella to the heart. And you will see that off when I show the finished layout. I did that off camera. I just thought that it needed a little bit of gold sparkle. So I colored the heart in with the gold Winkostella. And now I'm just kind of going around the edges of that punched circle where it has the coffee create sleep repeat quote on there. Just wanted it to pop a little bit more off of the page there. I felt like it kind of could blend in even though it has that gold that pops, but I wanted it to pop a little bit more. It's not super noticeable, but it did help. And you could do that with an ink pad just as easily as using a marker. I'm going to add just a little bit of this strip of paper to the top up there. I really wanted some more gold. And I forgot that this paper is not 12 inches long, and so I'm going to put it down and realize, oh no, it's too short, and I'm going to have to pull it back up and go ahead and put it back down, leaving a little bit of a space there. And I don't know why this paper isn't 12 by 12, but it's not. But it works out anyway. It was an easy fix. Now I'm just going to try to figure out which embellishments I want off of that sticker sheet there, and then where I'm going to place them. And I'm going to do a couple little clusters, and it ends up living down there. And that pumpkin was perfect, but I'm going to go ahead and punch out a piece of the pattern paper and actually add it so it pops a little bit more off of the page so it doesn't blend in so much. And you'll see that I go ahead and ink the edges with my ink pad this time. And it just kind of helps make it pop so it doesn't get lost on the page with the photos. All right, and now I think I'm going to adhere that down. And I'll be making a couple more clusters here and playing around with some of the embellishments. I did my journaling on the computer. It just makes for easy journaling, especially since this is pretty busy paper, the background with the words and then the striped paper. And I wanted to put it above the photo of me in that space below fall. And so I decided I wanted to pull a little bit more white into the layout. And so I'm going to just print it off and cut it apart. That also, the Love It was a stamp as well that I used, and I'm just looking through my inks and I'm going to ink it up because I felt like it needed more color. It was too white because I already have another stamped that I'm going to be adding on to the layout, which is up there in the left corner that you can see, and it's the same as far as the saying, coffee, create, sleep, and repeat. It's the exact same thing, and I want to keep that one white just to give it a, I need white, a little bit of white on the page because of the coffee cups. And so I'm going to just let that dry while I'm working on the rest of the layout, and then I'll come back to that and I will add it onto the layout. So like I said, I did all of my journaling off camera. I cut it apart, and I also did my title off camera, and I used some chip letters by Cosmo Cricut that are really old and they're kind of a wood grain. And then I also put some enamel dots onto the layout. And I realized that I'm trying to do more journaling on my layouts. And I was going through some of my scrapbooks and I realized that I did a lot of type journaling back in a lot of my older scrapbooks. And I really liked how that looked. And I liked cutting it apart. And I just felt like I needed to do that again. So I'm starting to get back into doing my journaling on the computer, and I think that I'll probably do it by hand and then cut it out as well when I don't feel like using the computer. But I like that I'm trying to get back into giving a little bit more details, maybe not the whole story, but a little bit of the story at least on some of my pages. So I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys continue to watch this. And I hope that you enjoy my process and seeing how simple and easy this layout is and how quickly it came together. If you have any questions, please leave them down below. And I'd love to know what you think and what you've been up to as far as if you're still into scrapbooking or what you're making. Thanks guys for always stopping by, and thank you for watching and leaving your comments and giving me a thumbs up. Thanks guys so much. We'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.